I want to congratulate you on another phenomenal season for the boys tennis team here at Weston High School. You're coming off another Southwest Conference championship for you seniors. This is your fourth in a row. Congratulations. And you're about to embark on your next run, which is your state tournament run. So I wish you well on that. Actually, when you see this, that will be done. People ask me all the time, how does our tennis team achieve at the levels it achieves year after year after year? And they incorrectly assume it's only because we have so much talent in this program. There's another piece to that puzzle, led by our head coach, Gary Munier. Gary, congratulations on another great season. Your program continues to amaze and astound. The things that people don't see behind the scenes are the Saturday morning practices, the sprints that are done in the rain or the shine, the classroom sessions, the chalk talks, the everything that you do behind the scenes, the plans that you put in place with your players, the communication to make sure that they can achieve on and off the court at the level that they've achieved. And that level is pretty amazing. 12 of the last 13 state championships have come to Weston High School. 12 of the last 13 SWC championships have come to Weston High School. Along with that, you've compiled a record of 132-21 over the last 10 years while going out and seeking the toughest competition you can find in the state of Connecticut. Double L schools, L schools, whoever's willing to play us really is who you go out to look for so that your boys have the opportunity to compete at the level that they become accustomed to competing at. So congratulations to all of you. I hope go Trojans.
In getting to spend some quality time with Gary, he's a special guy. You can't get anything more out of these kids than he does. And it takes a real good coach and motivator to do that. Gary takes no shortcuts. He works these kids very hard. And we have such good parents, and their attendance at games is by far superior to any other team in the conference, which is the willingness of these kids and the work ethic to continually never be satisfied and just continue to understand that running another mile or running more sprints, that it all is going to add up to a winning equation. And then their willingness to do whatever it takes to win. The bond that these kids share is special. It's to see them with their arms around each other and see them communicate and talk on the bus and just sit and oversee it and watch it. But this group of kids, I can't really eloquate it, but they're extremely special. You know, that win against Pomprock in the SWC final, I mean, I get emotional talking about it. It meant so much to me. That was so gutsy. You know, we're down a set on all four courts. That was a big one. And then the state tournament, and all my years of watching the state tournament, you know, I played 89-93 for Weston. We got two state championships back then, and each one was by a point. I've never seen a team run away with it on day one and see the expressions in the other coaches and the other players throughout the day. Like they went from hopeful to watching other guys to like the reality setting in that this was a one horse race. The last couple of months has been one of the greatest gifts I've received in a long time. So I do want to personally thank the parents and the team for letting me be a real small part of a huge thing that you have here. And let the success continue. State champions.
Yeah, baby.
Where was the intensity? If I had the ability to perform under pressure like you guys did, I never would have made it through that 22-inch wide tunnel. And Hoff, you look like you missed one more practice. I'm going to put you out in the desert with the scorpions. And Gosnell, if the ball was supposed to bounce twice, I'd be playing it Wimbledon. Tim, what did I tell you about flipping the racket? No matter how much we run, Ishan will never move his feet. The only time you move your feet is for a footfall.
It is so small.
You know, when I was in the desert of Ethiopia, I didn't see a woman for 4 months. I mean, I just don't think you guys know what it's like to play through pain. Do you guys even know what it's like to swim in 35-degree water? Do you even know what it's like to have to suck poison out of your own leg? The pressure is on. Get it together. Sexual prowess reminds me of those lions I once encountered in the Amazon. Guys, can we please focus? You guys remind me of the monkeys that I live with for 5 months each year. Let's cut down on the errors and focus on playing as a team. Hey!
The level of engagement by these three.
has been pretty extraordinary all season. I feel like I'm president of a fraternity rather than coaching a tennis team. I've never seen, even if you watch that series Brothers in Arms, you don't see as many brothers with their arms around each other as you do with this group of kids. It's really something special to be a part of, and even more special to be the coach of. So, Pranav, our free agent from Glastonbury. This is for Eric. This is my roommate in school. Eric lives in my office with me. And this is for Ishan, and he's my adopted roommate. This is gonna be the best day of my life.
Between Weston and Staples. Weston, meanwhile, has a solid number one doubles team of Pranav, Madden, and Tim Lautenbach. The Trojans have won 11 state championships in the last 12 years. Weston, though, has a chance to win its conference championship on Wednesday. They probably should do that, and they'll go for another state championship, trying to make it 12 and 13 seasons. Congrats to the Weston boys tennis team. The school tweeting out this photo after the Trojans beat Pomperog 5-2 Wednesday to win their 12th Southwest Conference title in the last 13 years. They did so by rallying in come-from-behind fashion.
Yeah. world. You brought me fame and fortune and everything that goes with it. I thank you all. But it's been no bed of roses, no pleasure cruise. I consider it a challenge before the whole human race, and I ain't gonna lose. It's we are the champions, my friends.
Next stop, Yale.
This is a world premiere.
I have been through a whole lot. Trial, tribulation, but I know God. Satan wanna put me in a bow tie.
Pray that the holy water don't go dry, yeah, yeah. As I look around me, so many motherfuckers wanna down me. But the enemy gon' never drown me. In front of a dirty double mirror, they found me. And I love myself.
The world is a ghetto, big guns and dick inside.
I love myself.
But they can do what they want when they
play
one, I don't mind.
I love myself.
He said I gotta get up.
Everybody looking at you crazy. What you gonna do? Lift up your head and keep moving. Well, let the paranoia haunt you. Peace to fashion police. I wear my heart on my sleeve. Let the runway start. You know the miserable do love company. What do you want from me and my scars? Everybody lack confidence. Everybody lack confidence. How many times my potential was anonymous? How many times the city making me promises? So I promise this.
Yeah!
The world is
real.
Because
it's
dicky
time. I love myself.
A police and a rock on a corner and a line full of fiend and a bottle full of lean and a motto on a scheme, yep. These days of frustration keep y'all on tuck in rotation. I duck these cold faces, post up, feed 5-4 for basis. Dreams are reality's peace. Blow steam in the face of the beast. The sky can fall down, the wind can cry now. The strong in me, I still smile.
I love myself.
The world is a ghetto, big guns and
dick
inside.
I love myself.
But they can do what they want when they want.
Weston wins the Class M state title. Get this, it's the Trojans' 12th state title in the last 13 seasons.
Three captains and I, we always say, you know, it's an incredible team. It's an amazing group of guys. It's almost like a family. So it's great to go out on top.
Certainly is. That was senior captain Eric Benninghoff.
State champ. Put that in your montage.
Feeling my way through the darkness, guided by a beating heart. I can't tell where the journey will end, but I know where to start. They tell me I'm too young to understand. They say I'm caught up in a dream. Well, life will pass me by if I don't open up my eyes. So that's fine by me. So wake me up.